Pole dancing is an activity that by no means originated in strip clubs. For centuries, cultures all around the world have developed their own kinds of pole dancing rituals and sports. In China, pole dancing dates back all the way to the 12th century, and today is still a common part of acrobatic acts. The Chinese pole dancers are so intense, they see burn marks from the pole as signs of respect. And then if you go to India, the pole dancing sport of Mallakam also dates back to the 12th century and became popularized in the 19th century, and even today holds championships across the country. Fun fact, Mallakam is usually a male-only sport. Then of course there's the whole European maypole tradition, which I really don't understand because it's just a bunch of people running around a pole and not getting tangled up and then, okay, I don't know how a maypole works. What we see in strip clubs today is a combination of pole dancing and the striptease, which actually dates back much farther than Chinese and Indian pole dancing, all the way back to ancient mythology. Women, in other words, have been seductively removing their clothes item by item since almost the dawn of time. In the United States, the way that pole dancing and striptease came together was a bit more by happenstance than some studious pole dancing scholar saying, "Look at this pole dancing happening in the Far East, let's bring it over to the US of A." In 1893, the Chicago World's Fair, a wildly successful producer named Saul Bloom had a hoochie-coochie dancer who was performing in one of his adult-only tents named Little Egypt.
Step right up, folks. Saul Bloom's the name. Hoochie-coochie dancer is my game. How did I get this wireless microphone? Who knows? What's a microphone? It's 1893.
Little Egypt was a massive sensation at the fair. The kind of dance that she was doing was a bit of belly dance, and they were at a fair, they were in a tent, and you know what holds up tents? Poles. As Little Egypt is doing her erotic belly dance and possibly removing some of her clothes in the meantime, she is dancing around a pole. In 1896, Thomas Edison actually filmed Little Egypt doing her signature moves for a short that he called the Coochie Coochie Dance. Thus we have the first instance in the United States, most likely, of that combination of the pole and the erotic Hoochie Coochie Dance. The term Hoochie Coochie Dancer derived from the Southern slang word coochie, referring to a woman's vagina. Or should I say, vagina. During the Depression era, when you have a lot of traveling fairs and carnivals going on, well, there are more hoochie-coochie dancers taking a cue from Little Egypt to draw the gentlemen in to watch them dance around the pole.
Scandalous!
In a nutshell, the reason why strippers today dance on poles is because Depression era men went to see hoochie-coochie dancers in tents. We've come a long way, and yet not so far at all.